Of the nuclear medicine for children with neuroblastomas. Great thanks for the organizing committee for this invitation. It is always a pleasure to present at a conference where not only diagnostic specialists are present, but also the medical doctors who are also decision makers based on our results. Around 50% of patients at initial diagnostics have remote metastasis, and it is no secret for you all. This all leads to the necessity of the use of various methods of imaging to define the primary focus and the risk factors, and the nuclear medicine, including scintigraphy and MEBG, play a great role in terms of defining the advancement of the process. MIBG was synthesized at the end of 1970s by Willand et al. And in 1984, neuroblastoma was visualized for the first time with high sensitivity and specificity. That's how normal physiological distribution of the radiopharmaceutical looks like. It is being accumulated in the pericardium, in the mucosa. We carry out the study targetly of the head in lateral projections. You see two patients here with the uptake in the primary focus and multiple lesions. The second patient with diffuse and bone lesions. It seems very simple. We have a specific label and can define everything and diagnose everything quite easily. But this is not that simple. There are some neuroblastomas that do not uptake MIBG. There are patients with MIBG positive and MIBG negative foci. We carry out these studies using special equipment, but the equipment is limited. The majority of the studies carried out up to 2005 were planar images, and they're still performed. SPECT CT technology allows to increase the sensitivity of planar images, but has its own disadvantages. We have low spatial resolution, which increases the time of the study very significantly, and the majority of the patients are children under 5, and they all practically all need sedation. And next, I will show you clinical cases and which protocols we use where. Planar images of two patients. To first view, no pathology, but we know that based on other methods of studies, in both cases, there were huge tumors in retroperitoneal that uptook MIBG. These are planar views of the next patient. We know that there is a tumor in retroperitoneum on the left. We see uptake on the left, but in SPECT CT, we see that the uptake on the left is nothing else but uptake or normal physiological uptake in the left adrenal gland, which is not changed based on CT, while the tumor is located lower at the level of the lower pole of the left kidney, and it is MIBG negative. Bilateral lesions in neuroblastoma, and to the first view, no metastasis. However, after targeted projection, lateral projections of the head were performed, we see this uptake that is concealed on planar image behind the uptake in the mucosa of the nose. This is SPECT, and this is nothing else but the lesion of the skull bones, which we see on MRI as well. If not for the planar images, we wouldn't be able to see this focus. The main thing is to differentiate between the uptake in subcutaneous foci or metastasis in the lungs. Based on the planar images, it is impossible to define which foci these are. You see both subcutaneous and in the lung, there were foci that uptook radiopharmaceutical. SPECT-CT protocol allowed us to differentiate non-specified uptake. Not so many works, but there are some publications which show that patients with pneumonia, in this case, the patient had bilateral pneumonia, and we see the uptake of radiopharmaceutical at planar images, quite intense uptake in the lungs projection. And only CT data allows us to understand that we see the density foci of the pulmonary tissue. Antibacterial therapy and the control study showed that the inflammation is diminished and the uptake of the radiopharmaceutical diminished as well. But the fact that it is non-specific stuff was only with the was possible only with the single photon CT combined with CT, and we also detected the uptake in the lower third of the femoral bone. MRI confirmed that there was a focus there, but not always the bone scintigraphy allows us to trustworthily visualize things. In this case, the scintigraphy was such that only very few specialists could define the lesions based on its data, but on scintigraphy, we see the total lesion of the bone marrow in this patient. We have analyzed the work and the patients for whom we carried out scintigraphy of the bones and MIBG, and have shown that no additional value was contributed by the scintigraphy in patients who had MIBG positive tumor or their metastasis. The only advantage was produced in patients with who had MIBG negative tumors. In three cases, the scintigraphy of the bones allowed to detect metastasis. Up to recent time, up to 2017, we had quite few works like this. Everybody understood that osteoscintigraphy hardly adds anything new. But in 2017, there was the first publication with the participation of the Donner Fabro Hospital that showed that scintigraphy, osteoscintigraphy, doesn't provide any benefits. As an option instead of osteoscintigraphy, PET is offered these MIBG negative patients. They do not uptake radiopharmaceutical based on PET CT. FDG. But what was important, we visualized multiple metastases, and in this case, we may help you grade this patient right. Everybody knows that during initial study, we may have multiple metastases in the process of the therapy. The number of the foci goes down. By the end of the therapy, no foci at all. And there's always a question from the oncologist to the radiologist, how to calculate this? Does it have any prognostic value? And there was a whole number of techniques offered. You see what kind of scores can be used. For example, Curie score, the body of the patient is divided into 9 segments. 10th segment is primary mass. And based on the last publication, it was shown that Curie score, if after the end of induction it is equals 2 or is less, the prognosis is better for the patient. But things are not as simple. Never mind whether this is Curie or Siopen with 12 segments. Everything is calculated based on the planar images. You see on the planar image of the patient, two foci, when we calculate, we give him a certain level of score, but in fact, this patient had another focus localized in the sacrum, but since it is behind the bladder on planar images and the activity of the bladder doesn't allow us to visualize this focus, and only PET CT allows us to see this focus. But to my opinion, the oncologists are worried for each and every focus. To my opinion, this is not that important when this is the initial study. What is important, the same patient, the end of therapy, and no foci of uptake are detected. Based on Curie, we would have put given him zero, but with SPECT CT, we see both the iliac bone, the sacrum, and even the lymph nodes all preserve their foci. We do not see them on the planar images due to low resolution, but SPECT CT allows us to see them. So scintigraphy with MIBG still remains the golden standard. The use of SPECT CT allows to differentiate physiological uptake from non-specific and pathological uptake in the small masses, may be seen with additional technique. Uptake in heterogeneous tumor that also may be negative on planar images. This technique allows us to very clearly differentiate if we see the uptake in the projection of the hip, whether the uptake happens in soft tissues or in the cortical layer. The assessment of response to therapy, semi-qualitative method is widely used, but to our opinion, SPECT will be of great importance. What are the disadvantages? Time of study. Even when we carry additional SPECT protocol of one area, it will take more than 90 minutes. If we have to study two additional zones for older patients, this means plus 35 minutes more. Collection of data, we do this 24 hours after the administration of the radiopharmaceutical, especially for not convenient for the patients who come over from remote regions. They have to spend 24 hours in Moscow, and the spatial resolution is quite low. Osteoscintigraphy, as I've said, it is still remains in ICD, in NB 2004. But if new data pop up, we'll probably indicate it for MIBG negative, PET CT with the FDG for MIBG negative patients. Spatial resolution is much better here. There is some anatomical correlation, and the time of study is 1 day, unfortunately. No specificity at all of FDG compared to MIBG, a lot of false positive results, especially after the start of therapy. With MIBG, we can do this. And I think that the trend will be towards PET, but with radiopharmaceuticals with higher specificity.
Why MIBG yet very attractive presently? As you can see, we do scintigraphy with MIBG and there is therapeutical domain MIBG, iodine-131. We can use this tracer for therapy. But currently, what's very popular, getting very popular, is PET with FDG, analogs to somatostatin traced gallium. And you, as you know, there is a big number of neuroblastomes or neuroblastomas. Cells are repressed in neurotestum receptors, and there are lots of publications showing very good imaging using the data from FDGs. The advantage is also that it's possible to use those analogs with somatostatin receptor to trace them by lutetium-3 beta detectors. So we can use it for therapy if we use those tracers. As we conduct studies on study, and there is all the information on the website. If you're referring the patients to us, you should find all the information for us to do it right. Thank you. I'll take you.